वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास प्लस टू सी. बेटा वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू पोएम कीपिंग क्वाइट रिटन बाय पाब्लो नेरुडा. द फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट थिंग इज यू नीड टू रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ द पोएट. सी व्हेन एवर वी आर डूइंग ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चंस दिस इज द फॉरमोस्ट थिंग यू शुड नो. एंड सपोज माइन्यूट ऑब्जर्वेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड इन ऑब्जेक्टिव पेपर. सपोज दे से व्हाट इज द The name of the poem written by Pablo Neruda. That can also be a question. So suppose they have given keeping quiet, a keeping, the keeping. In that way, they can confuse you in n number of ways. I'm just giving one example. Fine. Because we people are in habit of just avoiding the names and still we jump into what is there in the poem. So we have to read carefully the name of the poem, the name of the poet, and definitely a question will be there. Then before starting, let me tell you about the theme which we will be covering today. There are multiple themes of this poem and each stanza is going to touch different theme. Fine. There are themes of brotherhood, themes of preserving nature, then theme of you can say the people in power, how they can help us, then introspection being the base of this poem. That's why I have written here. So rest of the themes will keep on changing on daily basis, and the last day when we will conclude, then on Wednesday or maybe tomorrow, then I'll tell you all the themes. So today we are going to cover these themes only. Now you tell me that in layman's language, what do you mean by keeping quiet? Not to talk, hai na? In that way. But in this poem, actually poet is trying to ask all of us to take a break. You know, you just observe your life. What do? You wake up in the morning, you have stress, okay, I have to go to school. You go to school, you reach back home, you are under stress, okay, I need to go to the tuitions. Then you go for tuitions, and then again you come back home, then you see, okay, these assignments I'm supposed to submit to my school teacher, to my tuition teachers, then you go through that. Every time, and similarly teachers also, we people are also splitting our duties, fine? So every human being on this earth, he or she is busy. And we people are so busy that we stop looking at ourselves even. Fine, that sometimes we start hurting ourselves. We are going into distresses. People are having depression. Number one. Secondly, we people start exploiting Mother Nature also. Fine, we start, and exploitation doesn't come in one way, it can be in any form. In any form, fine? So, in this poem, poet is saying, let's take a break. Let's keep quiet for a while. Fine, when you have vacation, why do you have a Sunday after 6 days week? If there will be no Sunday, we people will be yelling at each and every person. It's a break time for us, weekend. That's why these days people putting on status, weekending and all. Actually, it is a relief to your mind that you wait for Sundays and weekends so that we can visit new places, meet our friends, hang out outside, fine, in that way. And similarly, summer break, winter break is there. And how happy we feel when there is holiday declared in the school. So this is the part of life. Everybody, every creature on this earth needs a break time. Fine. And we become so busy that we start ignoring ourselves. We start ignoring the people around us. We start ignoring the Mother Nature at large. So this is what Pablo Neruda is saying. Let's relish that moment, which is quite peaceful. And he's going to tell us the benefits of keeping quiet. Fine, what will happen if we keep quiet? Keeping quiet doesn't mean that sit at a corner, don't talk to anyone. Fine, in this poem, the contextual meaning. And it doesn't mean that you stop doing work. Poet will be telling us, it does not mean inactivity, that sit free and do nothing. No, that nothingness should be there, but it should be for a valid time only. And after that, what will happen? You rejuvenate yourself. On Sundays, you take break, you go out, you eat your favorite dishes, then you get rejuvenation. you refreshen up yourself. In that way, then on Monday, you have very energetic day. Fine. So this is the theme, that one should rejuvenate oneself. One should refreshen up oneself. Fine. Then one should restart. Fine. Rejuvenate, refresh, and restart. These three R's to remember in this poem. Let's start with the stanza-wise explanation. So Pablo Neruda, firstly, I'll read about. Let me share the screen for you all. Children sitting at home, beta, introduction is clear to you all. Send me thumbs up, come on. So I have shared the screen with you all. Fine, you can see I'm going to read about the poet Pablo Neruda. Pablo Neruda is the pen name of Neftali Ricardo Ruiz Bosalto, who was born in the town of Peral in Fine, Chile. Neruda's poems are full of easily understood images, which make them no less beautiful. He won the Nobel Prize for Literature in the year 1971. In this poem, Neruda talks about the necessity of quiet introspection and creating a feeling of mutual understanding among human beings. Underline. These are the main themes of this poem. Mutual understanding and introspection. You, these days, you see, we people start judging others without knowing them, because we people are so busy that we start misunderstanding others also. We have quarrels with our family, sometimes with parents, with siblings, with friends. Why? Because we are not giving ourselves a break. When we will give ourselves a break, we will be rejuvenated. We will have a time to think and introspect that where am I wrong? Aap bhi galat ho sakte ho, hamesha samne wala galat nahi hai. So when we get time to think, then there are less chances of fights also. You will try to understand others, fine? So this is what they're saying, that understanding among human beings, mutual understanding. Then, now we will count to 12 and we will all keep still. Before starting, beta, the children sitting at home, I would like to check whether you are there or not. Send me thumbs up, I would name the children. Within a second, beta, jaldi se. Yes, Sukhmanjot, Rana Gurjeet. Those who want, send me thumbs up, they're absent. Kakshi, Fateh, Suhani, Saransh, Gaurav. What about Palak Dhal and Mehak Vasan? Abhirup Singh, they're absent, I guess. Raghav is there. Yes, Mehak Vasan is there. Palak Dhal, you have not sent me thumbs up for that. Anushka is there, Amitoj is there. Palak Dhal is not there. Make sure Sukhmanjot is noting down the attendance. Fine. Let me continue. Palak has not sent thumbs up. Otherwise, everybody has sent. So they are absent for me, those who do not respond. Yes, Vita. Now we count to 12 and we will all still. We'll all keep still. You remember when you were a child, 1, 2, 3, start. This is the way we used to start the race or start any competition. Now, poet, why he is saying, let's count up to 12. Why didn't he say 1, 2, 3 only? Can anybody tell me why he chose number 12? Any idea, whatever, whether right or wrong. What comes to your mind when you think of number 12? Half? Yes, exactly. This is the answer. There are 12 hours in a day. 24 are there, but 12 hours of night and 12 hours of day. There are 12 months in a year. Fine. So number 12 actually is denoting time here. It is representing time, division of time. 12 hours in a day, 12 months in a year. So in that way, poet is saying, now we'll count to 12 and we all keep still. कहते लेट्स काउंट टू 12 हियर मींस लेट्स स्टार्ट द प्रोसेस ऑफ कीपिंग क्वाइट. वी विल नॉट मूव, वी विल बी स्टिल. फॉर वंस ऑन द फेस ऑफ द अर्थ लेट्स नॉट स्पीक इन एनी लैंग्वेज. पोएट पेब्लो नेरुडा सेज लेट्स एट लीस्ट फॉर वन टाइम लेट्स टेक टाइम, लेट्स एक्सट्रैक्ट टाइम आउट ऑफ अवर बिजी स्केड्यूल्स एंड लेट्स नॉट स्पीक इन एनी लैंग्वेज. Now here poet is trying to say, if we will not speak, why do people start doing arguments? Why there are fights amongst people? Because we do not speak good. Our words can create wars. You know, when someone says to us, we say, okay, isne mujhe ye bola, let me say this to him. And then our fights start. So poet is saying, let's not speak in any language. Let's not talk for a while. If we will not talk, there will be no fights even. That's why poet is saying, let's not talk in any language. Let's stop for 1 second and not move our arms so much. Not move our arms so much means, let's not do anything. Clear? Moving arms here means, let's not do any work. Let's not do anything. Let's be idle, free. Let's stop. Let's have a break for a while. Clear? So in crux, the first stanza, poet is asking us not to speak in any language. As a result, there will be no fights, there will be no confusion, no conflicts among people. Clear? And let's take a break for a second and let's not do any work. Okay? This is the crux of first stanza. Clear to all? Second stanza, very important word coming forward. It would be an exotic moment. In the first stanza, Pablo Neruda is saying, let's do this. Let's keep quiet. In second stanza, he's telling the outcome of what will happen if we keep quiet. Clear? The result of keeping quiet in second stanza, he's telling. It would be an exotic moment. Underline the word exotic. Strangely beautiful, strangely awesome, fine, heavenly moment, which cannot be compared with any other thing. That is, we say, no, this is exotic dish. I have never even tasted. You use this word quite often, but we don't know the meaning. Fine, extremely beautiful, strangely means out of this world, jisko aap kehte ho. That means exotic. Clear? So, it would be an exotic moment. Without rush, without engines. Now, beta, metaphors are used here. Engines. Without rush here means without the modern hubbub of life. Without, people are just hustle and bustle is there. People, you see on the any of the road, people are how they are busy running to their destinations. Even there are a lot of accidents due to that. People are in a mad race to reach somewhere or the other place. So poet is saying, if we keep quiet, if we do not do any work, it will be an exotic moment, heavenly moment, strangely beautiful moment. And there will be no rush. There will be no mad race without engines. Engines here means noise. What is an engine in layman's language? Engine is any machine. A car is working, there is engine. Fine, a refrigerator is working, there is again a machine in it. Any equipment, any vehicle, or any modern gadget working in our society has an engine in it, has a working thing. Fine. So poet here is saying that if we'll keep quiet, we will not do anything. It will be exotic moment, number one. And there will be no noise. There will be no chaos. Chaos means disorder. Fine. There will be no noise. There will be no chaos. And there will be no rush. And there will be no mad race of reaching at one place or the other. Clear? We would all be together in a sudden strangeness. Strangeness here means underline again. एग्जॉटिक मोमेंट. क्लियर? स्ट्रेंजनेस हियर मीन्स दैट सेम एग्जॉटिक मोमेंट. सो पोएट इज सेइंग इट वुड बी अ एग्जॉटिक हिट ऑल्सो मीन्स पीसफुल मोमेंट एंड मोमेंट ऑफ ब्रदरहुड एंड हैप्पीनेस. When people will be together, not fighting with one another, it will be very peaceful moment. Clear? So in the context of this poem, it will be in a sudden strangeness. So when we will all be together, what will happen? That exotic feeling will be there among people. That sudden strangeness. Which poetic device is used here in the line sudden strangeness? Yes, alliteration. What's the name, beta? Kanuba has given the exact answer. Sudden strangeness. Poetic device used here is alliteration, that is repetition of consonant sound. Clear to all? Second stanza. Yes, if I ask any one of you to explain, will you be able to? Children sitting at home, beta, clear to all? Second stanza is clear. If any doubt, you can write in the chat box. All of you are sending thumbs up, showing that it is clear. Now, third stanza, beta. Fishermen in the cold sea. See, I told you, each stanza carries different theme. This stanza is about this theme, preservation of mother nature. Fine, in this words, we'll be giving one particular theme. Fishermen in the cold sea would not harm whales. Again, in this stanza, poet Pablo Neruda is telling us that if there will be a moment of silence, if there will be silence prevailing and people will follow this norm, what will happen as the outcome of it again? Fisherman here means, beta, fisherman ko underline karo. It is symbolic of, write down, fishermen, they are symbolic of exploitation of mother nature. Symbolic of exploitation of mother nature. Fine. Will you remember it? Yes, Dipin, you're not writing. When we prepare for exams, beta, then you can forget any word. So write down. It takes just a second to note down, but it will help you a lot. Fisherman means symbolic of man's exploitation of mother nature. Fine. Exploitation by man. What we do when we are so busy that we forget that we are exploiting mother nature. So they have taken up example of fishermen. How fishermen exploit mother nature? They catch fishes. Fine. And there is whole cycle connected. One creature eats the other creature. Fine. In that way, they are saying that if fisherman is catching fishes and it will affect the environment or other creatures, the life cycle of all the creatures will get affected. Imbalance of nature will be there. So if there will be exotic moment, fishermen in the sea would not harm whales. And it also harm whales also. Clear? It means actually all the natural things all together exploited by all the human beings, they are saying. Clear? Contextual meaning. But example is given of fisherman. Is there any problem, beta? And the man gathering salt would look at his hurt hands. In the beginning, I told you, we people become so busy that we start hurting ourselves. Please get up from there and shift at the second desk. What's your name? Your good name, please. Yes, Anshulvich, please, roll number 7. And the man gathering salt would look at his hurt hands. Now, I told you, people start hurting themselves. How? Because we people are so busy. You just take the example of your parents. They're working or non-working. But why they are working? They're working for you people only. fine, they are earning money so that they can pay your fee, they can give you good health, good life, good eatables, fine. And sometimes even they start ignoring their health issues even. They won't visit doctors for months, for days. Fine, this is happening in many families. They start ignoring themselves. Later on, they have to, it comes to their health only. So here, what poet is trying to say? You know, how do we gather the salt? You know, that process is very tedious. At the seashore, when salt is gathered out of that sea water, you know that, na? That salt is gathered at the seashore only. So that accumulation of salt at the seashore, this process is very tedious and difficult. It hurts the hand of the man who's doing it. Sometimes there are huge cuts because that is very harsh substance. After refinement, we get the salt at our homes. Rock salt, suna hoga aapne. Fine. Many means processes are very difficult. So here poet is saying, if we will be quiet, man gathering salt would look at his hurt hands. It means when there will be moment of silence, people will be able to look at their own condition. They will be able to uplift their health. Fine, they will not harm themselves also. Clear? After Sundays and after vacation, how fresh you people feel. Mental health is the need of the hour. You know, many you can say young people these days, especially youth, they are suffering from one or the other mental issues and they do not know even. They are having anxieties. They are having anxiety attacks also. And people, you know, make fun of this thing. This is very serious. You might have heard the story of Deepika Padukone. Fine, how she combat that battle of depression. And depression is a serious mental disease. And why does it happen? Whenever desires are not fulfilled. When what we aspire, we do not become. Fine, our expectations are here and our hard work is here. How will it match? We people are not able to make our understand that if we are putting in efforts, the kind of results, sometimes even you put in efforts, you do not get results. So many factors are responsible for mental health. And if you will get a break out of your life, if you will be free enough to think, fine, only then you will introspect and self-analysis. Then you will find, okay, when I play guitar, I feel very soothing, I should do it. If I sing songs, I feel very happy, I should do it. Sometimes you people cry for no reason. Fine? So what? When we will able to give time to ourselves? When we are keeping quiet. Have you heard of those people? Many saints are there. They go deep into silence. They do not talk for 24 hours or 2 days or 3 days or a month even. और हमें कोई बोले 10 मिनट चुप करने को हम होते ही नहीं है. Very difficult it is. Fine? And give yourself some time to introspect, to heal. Fine? And then, yes, meditation, very good. So meditation is one part of this, you can say, meditating your own, brooding upon your own thoughts. Clear? So this poem is beautiful in every aspect. It is asking us to meditate upon our own thoughts, our life, our work. Clear?